Comet Tempel-Tuttle is never much to look at, even when it's closest to Earth, as it was in 1998 when this photograph was taken. You need a telescope to see it. But like all comets, it leaves behind a trail of particles, from the size of little grains of dust to big grains of sand. And when one of those particles encounters the atmosphere of Earth and streaks through the air, that's a meteor. The Leonid Meteor Shower is caused by the particles left behind by Comet Tempel-Tuttle. Occasionally, the Earth encounters thicker clouds of debris from Comet Tempel-Tuttle, and then you don't get just a meteor shower, you get a meteor storm. This is a picture from 1833 showing the great meteor storm that came with the Leonid Meteor Shower. This happens because the orbit of Comet Tempel-Tuttle intersects the orbit of Earth very closely. So when Earth passes through the place that the comet passed by, it's possible to encounter a thicker cloud of debris left by the comet. This visualization comes from a web application from NASA JPL, and we can use it to zoom out and see where the comet is now. Ooh, it's nowhere near Earth right now. It's been many years traveling away from Earth, and it'll be many years till it comes back to Earth. So there's not likely to be a strong cloud of debris there now for this year's meteor shower, but you never know. Sometimes we do hit some remnants of debris from Comet Tempel-Tuttle, and we have a good showing of the Leonid meteor shower. When should you look for the Leonid meteors? Well, the peak of the Leonid meteor shower is November 16th in the evening or the morning of the 17th. And I recommend after midnight when it's the 17th. With almost every meteor shower, you see more meteors after midnight than you do before midnight. So if you want to see this meteor shower, stay up late or get up early. And where do you look? Up. That's the great thing about meteor showers. You don't need to know a lot about which way to look. You don't need special astronomical instruments to look. You just go out, let your eyes get used to the dark, and look wherever it's clearest and wherever it's darkest. If the moon's out, moonlight can wash out the sky and make it harder to see meteors. And that's why I'm especially interested in the Leonid meteor shower this year, because the moon sets early. You don't have to look for the constellation Leo when you're looking at Leonid meteors, but you may if you want to. We have the computer program Stellarium in the background here, and it's set for November 17th at 2 in the morning. I'm looking east. There's some bright stars rising here. These are the stars of Leo, sort of a backward question mark shape here with a triangle here, not too far across from another group that you might recognize as the Big Dipper. And here I've outlined the constellation Leo so you can see how some people imagine these stars connected, the Big Dipper as well. The name Leonid meteors means the meteors of Leo, but that doesn't mean you'll see more meteors if you look at Leo. It just means if you see meteors and trace the tails back to where they came from, they will all converge on Leo. Leo is called the radiant of this meteor shower. I hope you get a chance to go out to your sidewalk or yard or rooftop and look for meteors, or better yet, go away from city lights where the sky is dark, and maybe you'll get a better chance to see meteors. But even if you see no meteors, maybe you'll enjoy the sky and make some discoveries about it. Go with an adult from your household. It's November, so dress warmly, and good luck.